Help! Help! All right, whatever. I'm Matthew Burchette, and this is Behind the Wings, and I can't get out! That's why that's painted yellow and black. I didn't have to be scared at all. It was just a lever. This is your viewer's choice, the F-104 Starfighter, and I'm in the front cockpit of this thing. It was called a missile with a man in it, and you can see why. I mean, this thing is not big, and sadly, there's not a lot of the instrument cluster left. Over the years, those things have disappeared, but that's okay. It is still super cool to be in one of these things. And I'm actually sitting in the ejection seat of an F-104C. Now, these guys originally ejected downward and not upward. That does not sound like fun to me. We've actually got one out on the floor. Let's go take a closer look at it. It's not exactly the same model, but it'll definitely give you an idea of what this thing was all about. I'm getting out of this before I get stuck in here. So, like we discussed in the cockpit, this is the ejection seat for an F-104. This one happens to be a high Q seat made by Stanley Aviation right here in Denver, Colorado. In fact, not too many miles away from where we are right now. Now, one of the cool things about this ejection seat is it actually used spurs. Now, why is this called a spur? Well, obviously, because it goes on your boot. You would literally strap this to the heel of your boot and then connect yourself to the seat. How cool is that? Now, like any other seat, to initiate the ejection, you just pull this handle. But then two things happen that are pretty much different than any other seat out there. Like we said, you're attached to the seat, but as you pull that handle, this cable sucks your leg back in. Then these come forward in these really heavy-duty nets, suck your arms to your body. Now, why do you want to do that? Well, if you're ejecting at like 2-point-something Mach and your arms and legs are flailing around, not only do you look silly and your other pilots are going to make fun of you, but you're probably going to end up breaking something. And of the two, that is definitely the worst part, because you don't want to have broken arms and legs when you're down on the ground trying to get away from the bad guys. So, let's go see some other things about the F-104 that make it such a cool plane. Not only the seat, but let's go check out the wings. You gotta have one of those in every episode, right? So, here we are at the wing of the F-104, which, when you think about it, is what makes an F-104 an F-104. This thing is tiny. It's a 55-foot long fuselage, but with a 20-foot wingspan. In 1954, when this thing made its first flight, Lockheed had figured out that the best wing for this airplane was a mid-mounted, trapezoidal, very thin airfoil. Now, if you look at a P-51 Mustang, the leading edge of that wing is huge. It's really big around. This, not so much. In fact, when these guys were on the ground, they actually had to put guards on the leading edge of this wing so the ground crew wouldn't beat themselves up and cut their arms and legs. That's nuts! Come here, check this out. You know, I could probably shave with this thing. My boss would be happier if I did that. Anyway, look at this. Look how thin this is. This is nuts. So what are you gonna put in this wing? I'll tell you, nothing. No gas tanks. No landing gear, nada. That's all down here. So all your gas tanks, your landing gear, was all in the fuselage. Now, they did have a couple of hard points on this thing, so you could put a bomb on it. Did that in Vietnam. Out on the wingtips, as you probably saw, we had some gas tanks. You could even put some missiles there. But for the most part, this wing was to make you go fast and to turn really large. This thing had a huge turning radius, like, say, the state of Nebraska, that big. But enough about that. Let's go see what made this thing go so fast, the super cool jet engine. All right, so these are the turkey feathers of the afterburner of the J79 engine. This monster, which took up a good 3/4 of this fuselage, remember, 55 feet long, so that's a big ol' engine, propelled this guy to Mach 2.2. That's over 1,400 miles an hour. No wonder they called it a missile with a man in it. Now, J79 was not without its problems. When the Germans started flying their F-104Gs, they had a huge problem with crashes. In fact, there was kind of a joke going around Germany. How could you get your own F-104 Starfighter? Easy, just wait for one and it would land in your front yard. Yeah, it didn't have a great safety record. In fact, it's got the worst safety record of all the Century Series fighters. But it still doesn't mean that this thing wasn't cool and did its job pretty well. Now, what we haven't done in a while is we have not given you guys a real behind the wings kind of moment, something that nobody else knows. We're gonna do that right now, and it involves the nose of this plane and something that's near and dear to my heart. I can't wait. You're gonna love this, come on. All right, so I wrote my master's thesis about nose art in World War II, so I geek out about anything nose art related. So, using your imagination, or maybe our super awesome cameraman can help you out, right here would be a giant pink pussycat cartoon. Yeah, buddy. This guy actually flew with that nose art when it flew with this 479th Tactical Fighter Wing in Udorn, Thailand during the Vietnam War. Oh my God, how cool is that? Very cool, in my opinion. So this guy actually flew out of George Air Force Base in California with the 479th, went to Vietnam, and then ended up with the Puerto Rico National Guard flying for them. That's a pretty good tour of service. That plane got around, and now we got it. Well, here I am again. Hopefully I don't get stuck like I did last time. Anyway, thank you guys so much for choosing the F-104 as your viewer's choice video of Behind the Wings, because it has been awesome. Stick with us, because next time we are going to the Space Symposium in Colorado Springs, and it's gonna be awesome. Really looking forward to that one. All right, so if you've got questions or comments, you know where to go, Facebook or YouTube, and we will answer them there. Also, if you would like to support Behind the Wings, please check out the link in the description of this video, because that would be awesome. And so we'll just still, oh no! Oh, oh, nope, oh, oh!